Greetings. Hi, I'm Dr. Walter Jacobson, a board-certified psychiatrist. You know, I want to talk about a patient of mine to give an example of the interesting way depression can work. You know, we talk about depression being a chemical imbalance, and the serotonin's off, and this and that is off, and you need medicine to kind of adjust the chemistry and get you out of a depression. And well, not necessarily, okay? I had a patient and he was very resistant to medications, very depressed, isolated in his room, didn't want to come out, didn't want to socialize, lost interest in things he likes to do, fatigue, impaired attention and concentration, no appetite, right? And we're trying different medicines, different antidepressants, and nothing is working. And every time he comes in, it's like I'm anticipating, okay, we're going to have to try something else because this guy's really, you know, the depression's really locked in. So lo and behold, he comes in like a couple of days ago, and he's like smiling. And I haven't seen him smiling ever. And he comes and he's smiling, you know, so he's not contracted and constricted and depressed and forlorn and all slowed down and numb. He's actually happy and smiling and feeling great. I'm not depressed. And he's feeling good. And so I asked him, well, huh? What? How did this happen? So it turns out that his brother was taking care of his mother, who was having problems with, you know, memory and the Alzheimer's and the aging thing and all that. And the brother was basically doing all the work to take care of the mother, right? The brother breaks his hip. Now he's incapacitated. He can't help the mother. He needs help. So my patient, he, you know, rises to the occasion, goes to help the brother, goes to help the mother, and in the process of helping, he gets out of his head. Suddenly he's energized. Suddenly he's not depressed. Suddenly he has purpose. Suddenly he has self-esteem. Suddenly it's unbelievable. But he couldn't spend time anymore just focusing on how depressed he was and how unhappy he was, because he needed to take care of these other people who he cared about. And so the depression went away. This is a very powerful. When we indulge our depression, when we give it power by sort of cooperating with the depression, cooperating with fatigue, cooperating with the lack of energy and drive, cooperating with the lack of motivation, in a sense, hoping that some medicine will kickstart and get us out of this mess. And in this case, right, it was simply a flip from self to other. Instead of like focusing on me, my problems, woe is me, I can't get out of this mess, I'm depressed, I'm a victim. He got out of himself. There were other people to help, service to others. And it was empowering. It was healing. The depression was gone. It was unbelievable. So in general, so the message is, you know, you do have a lot more power. Your mind has a lot more power to overcome depression and anxiety than you may think. And medicines ultimately can help, but really the real power is in the mind. The real power is in you taking control. Now, I know a lot of people are going to say, I can't do it. I'm so depressed. I'm so immobilized. I'm so fatigued. I have no energy, no desire, no nothing. I just can't lift a finger. I can't go for a walk. I can't do anything. Okay? I understand how debilitating depression can be. But at the same time, I encourage you to not take your depression laying down, to fight it, to push it, even though you don't feel like pushing it, even though you are so deeply depressed. Nonetheless, do what you can to get out of bed, to get out of your room, to engage with people, to engage with family, to take a walk, to walk the dog, to water the plants, to try to get back into your hobbies and interests. As hard as it is, push forward. Try to do it. Exercise is great for endorphins, for helping depression and anxiety and stress. So are meditation, eating right, sleeping better. Do what you can. Be as proactive as you can. Fight the impulse to stay depressed and stay stuck. And you really can empower yourself and pull yourself out of it and make your life better. Okay, that's it for today. But listen, hey, if you've got any questions, you know, let me know and I'll answer them in a video. If you have any suggestions for videos, topics that you'd like me to cover, let me know. I'm going to do it. That's it for today. Thanks. Take care. Peace be with you. See you next time.